Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe's Classic Video Games back with an amazing arcade game video for you this evening. I don't know if you folks are even ready for this one. Can you believe what we have here in our showroom? This is the original, dedicated, well, you know, kind of dedicated, I'll show you in a second, dedicated Capcom Street Fighter arcade game. I didn't say Street Fighter 2, I said Street Fighter. This is the very first one. Can you believe it? 1987, the original Capcom Street Fighter. Working good and looking good too. Still with us after all these years, 30 years. And we've got her back up and running. We figured, of course, we would take a video for our friends on YouTube. Now, there were two cabinets, there were, I guess, three ways that you could get Street Fighter 2. There was a kit that you could just put into any game, any cabinet. And there was this dedicated one, which was kind of the more traditional game, which kind of started the six-button fighting style. And then there was a huge version, too, that was also dedicated. That's the more famous one because it was so ridiculous. It had a big, huge control panel with big buttons that you would mash with your hand that were connected pneumatically to the game board. And depending on how hard you hit the button would change your kick or your punch. So, as you know, like on Street Fighter, they have jab, strong, and fierce punches. If you just barely touch the pneumatic button, it would do the jab. And if you hit it really hard, it would be fierce. So that cabinet is the one that everybody kind of always thinks about whenever they talk about the original Street Fighter arcade game because it was so unique. But this is also a dedicated Street Fighter one. It's missing the side art, unfortunately. Whenever we got it in, the side art had been peeled off. So we repainted it black. There was actually vinyl on the sides about halfway up, and then the top part was missing where the side art was. So we repainted it black. I wish somebody made reproduction side art for this, because if they did, I'd go ahead and put it on it. On the original, you can look online, you can find pictures of one that still has its side art, but basically it's got Ken on the side with his fist up here, I think, and it's kind of a caricatured drawing of them, kind of like that, similar to that, on the side with his fist up here, and he's over here screaming, and it goes down about halfway to about right here, kind of like how you saw some of the SNK games that we've filmed videos of, like POW and Guerrilla War, how they kind of had the half side art. This particular cabinet, unfortunately, it had been ripped off, and you can't buy reproductions yet. There's a couple gentlemen, I believe, working on making it, but they haven't got it done yet for this cabinet. I don't think you can get it, the reproduction for the big, huge, dedicated cabinet either. But so, since we didn't have the side art, we repainted it black like it should be, cleaned it up a lot, and then we put this yellow T-molding on it. Usually it's got black T-molding, but the yellow kind of... Since everything on it's black because the side art's missing, it's kind of plain. So we put the yellow on it to kind of play off of the marquee a little bit and give it a little bit of pizzazz. We think it looks pretty good. We'll probably sell this pretty quickly, but we'll tell whoever buys it. If we ever hear of the side art becoming available, we will let them know about it. So this is the original Street Fighter. You've got the marquee up here is in pretty good shape. It's a little worn, but this is Ryu, I suppose. Street Fighter. And there is Ken. I don't believe that's Vega. That's one of the other guys on this, because Vega wasn't in the original Street Fighter, so we'll have to see what that guy's name is. I'm sure you Street Fighter experts already know. There's Ken, of course, hitting the same guy that we were talking about. And there's Ryu kicking this guy. Street Fighter. This is the original control panel overlay. It's in pretty good shape. The control panel's bent a little bit, but it's pretty decent shape. You can get a reproduction of this, but this one was in decent shape. It's a little yellowed, but it's original, so we left it. Now, if you look, there's a couple interesting things about the control panel. We looked on the flyer, and the buttons on Street Fighter 2 were always red, white, blue. And that's kind of a Capcom thing. And later on, I believe they made it red, green, blue on things like Marvel vs. Capcom, things like that. But this was the first game with a six-button layout like this. And so instead of red, white, blue, they did it red, blue, white. And you can look on the flyer and see that that's correct. And if you see any more pictures of them, you might see that some of the buttons are replaced. But that's how they basically designed it originally. Another thing about it, too, is that these were... It was 1987, so it was shortly after micro-switch buttons started getting made. So those buttons that they put on these originally are horrible. The switches are built into the button, and they mess up all the time. So we always have to replace those. So, of course, all these are brand new. And then the other interesting thing is, if you look, if you're familiar with Street Fighter II or any of the later games, check out how they did it. It's backwards. So originally, the jab, the quickest punch, was on the right. The strong was in the middle, and the fierce was on the left. So it's reversed from where it is on Street Fighter II and pretty much every fighting game after that. On Street Fighter II or Marvel vs. Capcom or X-Men vs. Street Fighter or the 100 different games that have this layout on them, the jab's on the left, the strong's in the middle, and the fierce is on the right. Similarly, on the bottom, the short kick is on the left, forward kick's in the middle, and the roundhouse is on the right. But for whatever reason, in Street Fighter 1, they did it the other way, which isn't really wrong, because they were breaking new ground here, so they could have done it however they wanted. But I guess it's better to say, for whatever reason, on Street Fighter 2, they reversed it, and it's been that way ever since. So it's just kind of interesting. But it's a neat little game. The bezel on this one is in really good shape. It's just cardboard behind a piece of plexiglass, like most of these Dynamo cabinets. Dynamo was the name of the company that made the actual cabinet for a lot of the manufacturers around this era. A lot of the Dynamo cabinets would have this same setup. They'd have a little cardboard bezel and a plexiglass piece over the front of it. But it's got a nice look. So anyway, we'll read it a little bit. How to play. Insert coins and press one player or two player start button. Player 1 can select a country by moving the joystick to the right. Second player can join in at any time. Each match consists of best out of 3 rounds. Typical. Winner is the first player to win 2 rounds. Typical. Bonus round play. Timing and strength determine how well you score. So that's the famous bonus rounds. We'll see what those are about here in a minute. Your controls. Use the joystick. Now remember, this is the first Street Fighter. Nobody had ever heard of this before this. Your controls. Use joystick and 3 punch buttons to throw a variety of punches against your opponent. Use joysticks and 3 kick buttons to throw a variety of kicks against your opponent. Each button has a different level of strength and causes damage accordingly. Pull the joystick back to retreat to defensive position. Discover secret techniques by various combinations of joysticks and buttons. So there are secret techniques in the game, and you got to remember, at the time, nobody knew what the hell Street Fighter was. So it had the fireball in it, it had the dragon punch or whatever it's called in it, Shoryuken. Well, it had the hurricane kick in it. And so you could figure that stuff out if you screwed around with it enough. I think he just did it while I was talking about it and missed it. But so it must have been really exciting. I never played Street Fighter 1 back in the day, but I did play Street Fighter 2, which I think came out in 91. I did play Street Fighter 2, and at the time it was incredibly exciting. So I imagine, to the locations that actually got the original Street Fighter, it was probably pretty cool. Now, the only problem with Street Fighter 1 is the game just isn't as smooth and just isn't as good of a game as Street Fighter 2. They really fixed it up a lot whenever they made Street Fighter 2. There you saw the fireball. Oh, there it was! Dragon Punch. So, this game is not as good as the later Street Fighters that came out, but, here we are 30 years later, and it's since Street Fighter went on to be one of the greatest series of all time. It's kind of a collector's item, really. So if you put a quarter in and you press the left player button, you can be Ryu. And if you put a quarter in, if you press the right player button, you can play through as Ken on just the right side, I believe. And if you put 2 quarters in, you play Ryu versus Ken. You play a 2-player version. You don't get to pick your player. And Ryu and Ken are, as far as I know, the exact same character on this game. It's just the palette swapped a little bit. They've got the same moves and everything. And there's also several characters in the game that were never used again. And there are a few characters that they brought back for like Street Fighter Zero later on. And then, of course, the final, you fight through several countries, and you fight two people in each country, right? And when you get to the final fight, you go to Thailand, right? And in Thailand, you fight Sagat. And he's, I guess that's how you pronounce it. You fight Sagat, and he's the bad guy at the end, right? I probably won't get that far, because I haven't played Street Fighter 1 enough to be any good at it. But you get to Sagat at the end, and he doesn't have his scar on him, right? And he doesn't have his eye patch. And the lore of Street Fighter 2 is that whenever Ryu, there he is, made it to the end of Street Fighter 1 in the championship fight, whenever he fought Sagat, the way he beat him was he hit him with his dragon punch, and it scarred his chest, and it took out his eye, right? And so in Street Fighter 2, Sagat has this big scar across his chest, and his eye, he's wearing this eye patch that he doesn't have in this game. So Capcom was really cool about, you know, for a while, or I don't know if they're still this great at it, but for a while, giving cool little backstories in their games and linking little things together like that, so really made it a fascinating game. But what I'll do is I will get the tripod, we'll set it up, and we'll play through it a little bit, and you can see what the original Street Fighter was like. Check out how it's got the different, like, the Avengers, Trojan, Commando, Wings, Legendary Wings. It's got the different Capcom names on it. Now, whenever you start, it asks you if you want to start in Japan or you want to start in the USA. And you fight two fighters in each country. And I looked in the manual, you know, just trying to see what the dip switches were set on and all that. And it looks like on at least the... I couldn't find the manual for this version. I could only find the manual for the big pneumatic button version. It looks like you can actually set it with the dip switches to start in whichever country you want. So you can set it where you can start in Thailand, for instance. But I couldn't figure out how to do that on this one. So on this one, we'll just have to start in Japan or the United States. But hey, let's play through it. I turned up the sound so you can hear. Well, that's another thing. Street Fighter 1, the sound wasn't as good as Street Fighter 2 either, so it sounds a little muffled, and that's how they sound. You can see how much better they did with Street Fighter 2.
USA.
That. Man, I beat the hell out of him. Awesome. Trying to do the dragon punch. What strength? Okay, here comes Mike. Don't want none. I can't do the fireballs and stuff at will on this one, really. Thank you. out if it's the exact same moves. It seems a little different. But don't forget. Okay. I just hit the buttons a bunch. Japan! Retsu. Wait a minute, you know how you do it? You hit the button and then do the movement. You don't do the movement and then hit the button. You hit the button and then do the movement. Let me see if I got that right. That's confusing. I'm gonna get the hang of it, people. I mean, I'm still winning. Geki. Notice how quick the rounds are, too. There's a setting on the dip switches to slow it down, too, but it says this is normal. You can't make it faster. You can only make it slower. Wish I could get my damn mojo running on the fireballs. Might need a quarter, folks. Somebody loan me a quarter. Bastard. I guess fireballs don't work good against him. Let's see what we can do. I cannot not get it to do my moves. And he's taking me to town. Oh, I almost came back for it.
Round three.
He didn't like that. Damn. Man, he kicked my ass on national television. We'll keep trying, folks. This can't stand. Deal with it. What the hell? Tough game, folks. With a special anything, fireball, dragon punch, hurricane kick, it takes a third of their power. So if you can pull off the freaking moves. Second credit and try to figure out the moves. Oh, come on. It's just not as smooth, man. On Street Fighter 2, you can do roundhouses and knock them out of the air and stuff. I'm sure there's like a... If I can get the hang of the moves, I'll do a lot better. Damn. Tough stuff, folks. Tough stuff.
Try again, kid, he said.
Uppercut twice, but I didn't get him all three times. Holy crap! I gotta get these moves down. Strong. See if I can figure out how the hell what I'm doing wrong. Ken's going to be my whipping boy. All right. When you push the button, look at this. Yeah, they hit when you let go of the damn button. So okay, so usually on Street Fighter 2, when you hit the button, it punches. On this one, when you let go of the button, it punches. So damn, it's so weird. So I'm hitting the button, and then if I let go, he punches. So it's backwards. I wonder if you could hold the button and then do the move and let go of the button. Maybe you gotta hit it twice. Okay. Okay, so Very confusing, folks. Why the hell would they design it like that? Not this guy again. Get the hang of the fireballs. Thank you. said I go Street Fighter 2, I would have nailed him with a dragon punch there, and it would have been over. I don't know, folks. Tough as hell. That's what I got to say. I'm glad they reversed it whenever they did Street Fighter 2, because it made it a much more playable game. It's just so hard to get the timing right. But there you have it. That is the original Street Fighter. Now, by the time you see this video, Street Fighter may have Shoryukened its way over to somebody else's house. So we may not have it anymore. You can check out all the games that we do have in right now on our website. Go to LionsArcade.com. LionsArcade.com. Or you can stop by and see us. We're in downtown Rock Hill, South Carolina. Maybe you guys can come down here and show me what the hell I'm doing wrong. We're in downhill Rock Hill, South Carolina, a little bit south of Charlotte, North Carolina. And if you're not local, so you can't come by, just subscribe to us here on YouTube. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to us. And I will see you on the next video.